So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another class of PIB 247. In today's session, we are going to talk about the PIB news from 21st and 22nd of December 2022. So yeah, without any delay, let's begin with the session and I hope your preparations are going well. Please don't wait for the notification. ठीक है, जो भी आपकी प्रिपरेशन है, जब जैसे भी आप कर रहे हो, सेल्फ स्टडी या फिर थ्रू एनी कोर्स, तो स्टार्टेड एंड स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम टुडे ओनली. ओके, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच इज अबाउट अ स्कीम विच इज नेम्ड एज मुस्कान. सो व्हेन वाज मुस्कान स्कीम लॉन्च बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर टू प्रोवाइड हाई क्वालिटी एंड सेफ चाइल्ड फ्रेंडली सर्विसेज इन पब्लिक हेल्थ फैसिलिटीज एंड कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू प्रिवेंटेबल न्यू बॉर्न चाइल्ड मोर्टेलिटी एंड मोर्बिडिटी. So you just have to tell the launch year of the scheme, right? The question is about the launch year of the scheme, but yes, let's talk about the scheme in detail. So what is this Muskaan scheme? First of all, it is being implemented by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, right? And the objective, the major objective of this scheme is to improve the child healthcare facilities up to 12 years of age, right? For children up to 12 years of age. So the objective is to improve the quality of care at public health facility for children up to 12 years of age group, right? That is the major objective of this scheme and ministry is clear, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare headed by Mansukh Mandavia. Now if I talk about the objective more, so agar hum thoda aur deep mein jaye objective ke, so the objective is to accelerate efforts towards reduction of preventable, right, whatever the maternal mortality and morbidity are preventable, unko hum reduce karne ki koshish karenge through this scheme which is known as Muskaan. Now how will we reduce that? How will we do that? So it will be done by improving quality of care during the delivery and immediate postpartum period. What is postpartum period? The period just after the childbirth up to 6 weeks, right? Like today a child is born, it's let's say 25th December today. So 25th December ke 6 hafte tak, that is known as what? Postpartum period, right? So this we can reduce the preventable maternal mortality and morbidity by improving the quality of care at public health facilities, right? And it was launched last year 2021. It specifically focuses on the care around birth provided in the labor room and maternity operation theater. So basically labor room or maternity operation theater mein jab child birth hota hai to us dauran jitni bhi care ki ja sakti hai children ek child ki, उसके लिए ये स्कीम वर्क कर रही है. ऑलराइट, नाउ इट हैज बीन इनिशिएटेड इन ऑल गवर्नमेंट मेडिकल कॉलेज हॉस्पिटल्स ऑलरेडी, डिस्ट्रिक्ट हॉस्पिटल्स एंड इक्विवेलेंट हेल्थ फैसिलिटीज ऑल डिजाइनेटेड एफआरयूज व्हिच इज फर्स्ट रेफरल यूनिट्स. व्हाट इज फर्स्ट रेफरल यूनिट? फर्स्ट रेफरल यूनिट, सो दीज आर बेसिकली अगेन फर्स्ट रेफरल यूनिट. So these are basically the health facilities where round the clock newborn child care is being provided, right? And the high case load child healthcare centers. ठीक है, now this is the strategy which is being followed while implementing this scheme. Like what government is doing, so the government is strengthening the clinical protocols and management processes, children and parent attendant friendly ambience and infrastructure is being created, strengthen referral and follow up services after the child is born, right, and provision of respectful and dignified care. So basically along with proper treatment and proper care of child, other things will also be considered, like for example attendant friendly ambience, provision of respectful and dignified care, right? So ab hum kyunki after 75 years of independence hamari ab healthcare facilities thodi si improve ho chuki hai, so we should focus towards these parameters as well, right? And this scheme is doing it well. So now let's come back to the question. The correct answer to this question would be option E, 2021, because that is the year when this scheme was launched. Let's talk about question number 2 then. Identify incorrect statement about technology incubation and development and entrepreneur which in short is TIDE 2.0 scheme. Now this scheme is again based, this question is again based on a scheme. So let's talk about this scheme, and again it is in news because a reply has been submitted by the Ministry of Electronics and IT regarding this scheme in the parliament, right? So let's talk about this scheme. So first of all, if I talk about the objective, very easy. What is the full form? Technology incubation and development of entrepreneurs, right? That is the full form. So From the name itself, it is very clear that under this scheme, the government is providing support to the entrepreneurs. The government is preparing the entrepreneurs by providing support to the incubators. All right. So to promote tech entrepreneurship through financial and technical support to incubators. Okay. Now these incubators are those who are engaged in supporting information and communication technology startups using emerging technologies like artificial intelligence, internet of things, machine learning, etc. Right? I hope the objective is clear. It was launched in the year 2019, and as you can see, it is TIDE 2.0. So when was the first edition launched? So it was in 2008, right? Ministry is very clear, it is Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. The implementation of this scheme is being done through 51 TIDE incubation centers, right? Jitne hamare desh mein 51 TIDE incubation centers jinhone banaye hain. And these incubation centers are being provided with the financial and technical support. And these incubation centers are promoting tech entrepreneurship in the country by providing support to the startups. All right, I hope I'm clear. The overall outlay is 264 crore for a period of 5 years. And it is expected that it will provide incubation support to more than 2000 startups during its implementation period of 5 years. All right. And these are the areas of focus. These are the areas of focus where this tech entrepreneurship is being promoted under this scheme. These are healthcare, education, agriculture, financial inclusion, infrastructure and transportation, environment and clean technology, clean energy solution, and other emerging areas. And you remember that you don't have to remember all these areas of focus. That is not required for the exam. It is just for your understanding that in which area the scheme is working. All right. So now let's come back to the question. You have to identify incorrect statement. It was launched in 2019 by Ministry of Science and Technology. So the very first statement is incorrect, which means the correct statement will be option A. Why it is incorrect? Because it is being implemented by Ministry of Electronics and IT headed by Ashwini Vaishnav. All right. So let's move ahead to question number 3 then. SAMRIDH, which stands for Startup Accelerator Program of MeitY for Product Innovation, Development and Growth. Again, this scheme is for providing support to the startups. So there are a lot of schemes which are providing support to the startups in one or the other way. Similarly, this scheme is there, SAMRIDH. It is being implemented to further the Indian startup growth. So you have to identify the correct statement. All right. So let's talk about this scheme. And again, it is not a new scheme. It is in news because a parliamentary reply has been submitted by the ministry, right? Objective is very clear, to support the startups. Now, isme startups ko support kaise diya ja raha hai? By providing existing and upcoming accelerators. Theek hai, accelerators kaun hote hain jo ki startups ko taiyar karne mein help karte hain. Theek hai, who help the startups to prepare themselves, right? Or to prepare themselves in launching their products. Theek hai? So to support existing and upcoming accelerators to further select and accelerate potential software product based startup scale. Jitne bhi hamare software product based startups hai, unki scalability ko badhayenge ye accelerator. And these accelerators are being supported through this scheme. All right. Launch year, same 2021. Ministry, again, Ministry of Electronics and IT. All right. The implementing agency for this scheme is MeitY Startup Hub. Okay, MeitY stands for what? Ministry of Electronics and IT. For those who don't know this, MeitY is what? Ministry of Electronics and IT. So it is being implemented by MeitY Startup Hub, which is a nodal entity to interconnect deep tech startup infrastructure across the country. All right. And remember, the investment is up to rupees 40 lakh to a startup. Ek startup ko maximum 40 lakh investment is being provided under the SAMRIDH scheme of Ministry of Electronics and IT. All right. And it focuses on accelerating 300 startups in 3 years by providing them customer connect, by providing them investment connect, by providing them international connect to the international markets, etc. All right, so that is all about the scheme, and let's identify the correct statement now. It was launched in 2021 by MeitY. Yes, under its support is provided to existing and upcoming accelerators to further select and accelerate potential software product based startups to scale. सही बात है. Now, yes, let me clarify one thing here. So, see, there are various schemes which are providing support to the startups, right? Like we have Stand Up India, we have Startup India, we have Samrid, and we have that scheme Tide. बहुत सारी और भी हैं जो कि हमने पढ़ी है. But how will you differentiate between these schemes? कैसे differentiate करोगे? Let's say कि exam में कोई question आ गया, para-based question, that उस paragraph में, in that paragraph, the objective of the scheme is mentioned. Now, how would you identify which scheme is this, right? So you have to focus on the keywords. Like for example, if I talk about Samrid, Samrid scheme is providing support to the accelerator. So here accelerator is the keyword, right? Now if I talk about the Tide, in Tide, what is the keyword? The keyword is incubator, because the government is providing support to the incubators. So this is how you can make the difference. All right, and ye difference karna zaruri hai, because एग्जाम में तो कंफ्यूज हो जाओगे ना, बिकॉज देर आर अ लॉट ऑफ स्कीम्स विच आर प्रोवाइडिंग सपोर्ट टू द स्टार्टअप्स, राइट? सो यू हैव टू कीप अ फोकस ऑन द कीवर्ड, राइट? तो अब आ जाते हैं क्वेश्चन पे. आई होप द कंफ्यूजन इज क्लियर. सो दिस इज करेक्ट, दिस इज करेक्ट. माइट स्टार्टअप हब इज इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी ऑफ द स्कीम, दिस इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट. इट सीक्स टू एक्सेलेट अराउंड 300 स्टार्टअप इन 3 years, दिस इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट. एंड अंडर इट इन्वेस्टमेंट अप टू 40 lakh इज प्रोवाइडेड बेस्ड ऑन द ग्रोथ स्टेज ऑफ द स्टार्टअप. सो ऑल द स्टेटमेंट्स आर एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट, विच मीन्स ऑप्शन ई विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर, ऑल ऑफ द अबव. क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 पे आ जाते हैं, विच इज अगेन बेस्ड ऑन अ स्कीम विच इज दिशा. सो देर आर 4 स्कीम्स. अभी तक हमने 4 स्कीम कर ली है आज, एंड यू नो द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स इन आरबीआई ग्रेड बी एग्जाम, राइट? तो आज का सेशन बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है आपके लिए. Identify incorrect statement about designing innovative solutions for holistic access to justice scheme. तो objective तो I hope आपको clear हो गया होगा. The objective is to provide access to justice to all the citizens of the country, right? Whether that person is unserved, underserved, privileged or unprivileged, कोई भी हो, access of justice provide कराना is the major objective of this scheme. Now, how this access to justice will be provided? By designing innovative solutions for it, right? So basically, to create awareness and to create innovative solutions to provide access to justice to the people, to the citizens of India, this scheme is being implemented by Ministry of Law and Justice. All right. So I hope the objective is clear. It was launched last year again, 2021, by Ministry of Law and Justice, headed by Kiran Rijiju. Right? Who is the minister? Kiran Rijiju. Talking more about this scheme. So, duration is for a period of 5 years, up to 2026, financial outlay 250 crores. And there are various programs which have been submerged under this scheme. Number one, Telelaw. Telelaw, as the name suggests, it is an e-connect platform to empower people through pre-litigation advice, right? Through the Telelaw program, the Ministry of Law and Justice is providing the pre-litigation advice to the people, right? Then we have Nyay Bandhu, which aims to create a pan-India framework for dispensation of pro bono legal services, all right? Taki jaldi jaldi case khatam ho sake. Then we have Nyay Mitra, which aims to facilitate expeditious disposal of those cases which are still pending in high courts and subordinate courts for more than 10 years or 15 years. Okay? And then we have legal literacy and awareness, through which legal literacy will be created among those sections of the society jo ki unserved hai, underserved hai, ya illiterate hai, and awareness will also be created among them. All right? So that is all about the scheme, and let's try to identify the incorrect statement. So it is being implemented by Supreme Court. Nahi bhai, no. It is being implemented for a period of 5 years, period from 21 to 26. No problem, absolutely correct. It has financial outlay of 500 crores. No, that's 250 crores. And it consolidates and merges access to justice programs such as these. Theek hai, ye bhi sahi hai. So the incorrect is 1 and 3, right? 1 and 3, option B will be the correct answer. I hope this scheme is also clear. And let's move ahead to another question, which is about Pejal Sarvekshan. So Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, headed by HS Puri, Hardeep Singh Puri, has started the ground survey of Pejal Sarvekshan under Atal Mission for Rejuvenation and Urban Transformation 2.0, which is Amrut 2.0. So you have to identify the incorrect statement about the survey. Okay, so let's talk about it and then we will come back to the question. So the news is that Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has launched the ground survey of Pejal Sarvekshan under Amrut 2.0. This will serve, ground survey will serve as a monitoring tool and accelerator for the Amrut mission. ठीक है, ये Amrut mission के लिए एक accelerator tool का काम करेगा this survey. And talking about the Pejal Sarvekshan, the objective of Pejal Sarvekshan, drinking water survey. Pejal Sarvekshan means what? Drinking water survey. To assess the service level compliance of the city with respect to quantity, quality and coverage of water supply, number one. Sewage and septage management, number two. Extent of reuse and recycle of used water, number three. And conservation of water bodies in 500 Amrut cities. Now, one more very important information you should remember, that somewhere, agar aapko ye dikhe ki 485 cities under Amrut, then that would be again correct. Why? Because some cities have been merged, right? And now the number is 485. To kahin kahin pe aapko PIB mein ya newspaper mein agar 485 number of cities dikhai di Amrut mein, तो वो भी सही होगा, नो प्रॉब्लम विद दैट, बिकॉज सम सिटीज हैव बीन मर्ज एंड नाउ द टोटल नंबर इज 485. ठीक है, नाउ रिमेंबर दिस सर्वे पेयजल सर्वेक्षण इज बीइंग कंडक्टेड बाय अ थर्ड पार्टी विच इज इप्सोस. इप्सोस नाम याद रखेंगे. एंड फोकस एरियाज आर दीज: वॉटर यूटिलिटी सर्विस, यूज वॉटर यूटिलिटी सर्विसेज, वॉटर बॉडीज, नॉन रेवेन्यू वॉटर एस्टिमेशन एंड बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेज एंड इनोवेशन. ठीक है, नाउ दिस इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ सर्वेक्षण एंड आई डोंट थिंक इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन. जस्ट गिव अ ब्रीफ रीड टू इट. इसको एक बार बस हल्के से पढ़ लेना, दैट वुड बी मोर देन इनफ. ठीक है, सो लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन देन. लेट्स आइडेंटिफाई इन करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. इट विल बी कंडक्टेड इन 500 अमृत सिटीज. सही बात है, सो 500 विल बी करेक्ट एंड 485 विल बी करेक्ट. ठीक है ना, तो दोनों ही करेक्ट होगा, तो प्लीज डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज. एमओ हुआ हैज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स हैज एंगेज द थर्ड पार्टी एजेंसी इप्सोस टू कंडक्ट दिस सर्वे. एंड यस, यू मस्ट बी वंडरिंग कि अच्छा दोनों आ गए तो हम क्या करेंगे, 500 भी आ गया 485 भी आ गया, तो 500 ही मार्क करना बिकॉज गवर्नमेंट इज स्टिल सेइंग 500 अमृत सिटीज. ठीक है, सस्टेनेबल रेन वॉटर हार्वेस्टिंग इज वन ऑफ द 5 फोकस एरिया. देर इज नो सस्टेनेबल रेन वॉटर हार्वेस्टिंग अमंग द फोकस एरियाज. Let's check once again. वैसे नहीं है, I'm sure. Yes, there is no sustainable rainwater harvesting in the as one of the focus area. So this will be the correct answer because we have to identify one incorrect statement. Option C is the correct answer. And let's move ahead. Two questions in short, which do not need much explanation. But before that, if you want to have the PDF of this session, join the Telegram channel. The link is in description. डिस्क्रिप्शन में आपको लिंक मिल जाएगा. एंड इफ यू वांट टू आस्क एनीथिंग रिलेटेड टू एग्जामिनेशन, यू कैन फॉलो मी हियर. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. एज ऑन 31st अक्टूबर 2022, अ टोटल ऑफ 172.72 गीगावाट ऑफ कैपेसिटी फ्रॉम नॉन फॉसिल फ्यूल सोर्सेज हैज बीन इंस्टॉल्ड इन द कंट्री. सो यू हैव टू अरेंज द फॉलोइंग इन डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर एज पर द इंस्टॉलेशन कैपेसिटी. सो हियर यू कैन सी द मैक्सिमम इज इन सोलर. ऑफ कोर्स सोलर में सबसे ज्यादा है. देन लार्ज हाइड्रो पावर प्लांट्स, विंड एनर्जी प्लांट्स, बायो पावर विच मीन्स बायोगैस प्लांट्स और अदर न्यूक्लियर पावर प्लांट्स एंड स्मॉल हाइड्रो पावर प्लांट्स. ठीक है, दिस इज इन द डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर ओनली. सो अब लेट्स आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट आंसर. तो ये डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर में ये ऑप्शन दे रखा है, आई थिंक सोलर. ओके, देन लार्ज हाइड्रो 1, देन 4, देन विंड 1, 4, 2. And then it should be biopower 3 and then 5. 1, 4, 2, 3, 5 should be the correct answer. Yes, 1, 4, 2, 3, 5. Option C is the correct answer. I hope this is clear. Central government has been implementing ethanol blending program throughout the country, wherein all marketing companies sell petrol blended with ethanol. Ethanol is C2H5OH, right, which is a prime ingredient of alcohol. Under EBP program, government has fixed the target of dash and dash blending of ethanol with petrol by 2022 and 2025. In fact, the target of 2022 has been already achieved, okay, which is 10%. And by 2025, the target of ethanol blending is 20%. It is a very easy question. But ठीक है, जो लोग नए हैं उनके लिए उनके लिए नया हो सकता है, बाकी जो पुराने हैं उनके लिए रिविजन. 10-20 ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8. As per the provisions mentioned in the Schedule 2 of MNREGA, wage seekers is entitled to receive payment of compensation for the delay at the rate of how much percent of the unpaid wages per delay beyond the 16th day of closure of muster roll. ठीक है, ये एग्जैक्ट वर्ड्स पीआईबी में मेंशन थे कि अगर डिले हो जाता है तो उसके लिए कॉम्पेंसेशन कितना मिलेगा, हाउ मच परसेंट ऑफ द वेज रेट, राइट. सो दिस इज 0.05%. ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 9. विच ऑपरेशन इज बीइंग अंडरटेकन बाय आरपीएफ, विच इज रेलवे प्रोटेक्शन फोर्स, टू टेक एक्शन अगेंस्ट ट्रैफिकिंग ऑफ ड्रग्स वाया रेलवेज एज पार्ट ऑफ इंडियन रेलवेज sincere efforts to curb drug trafficking through their network. Very easy question, we have discussed it earlier as well, but for new people, it is Operation Narcos. Option B is the correct answer. What is the total length of dedicated freight corridor, a mega infrastructure project undertaken by Indian Railways for dedicated freight movement? So we have two DFCs in the country. One is Western, which is from Dadri to JNPT. JNPT is Jawaharlal Nehru Port Trust. And then we have another one, which is Eastern, which is from Ludhiana to Sonnagar. So these are two DFCs across the country and the total length is 2843 kilometers. Option D. Question 11. Which ministry under Samudrayan Mission? So yahi pe aapka answer khatam ho jana chahiye, uske aage aapko question padhna hi nahi chahiye. समुद्रयान मिशन है और मिनिस्ट्री पूछ रहा है, क्या होगा आंसर जल्दी बताओ. इट इज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ अर्थ साइंसेज हेडेड बाय डॉक्टर जितेंद्र सिंह, दैट इज इट. उसके आगे क्वेश्चन पढ़ूंगा ही नहीं, ठीक है ना. एंड यस, देयर इज अ मच 6000 व्हीकल व्हिच विल गो डीप डाउन द ओशन टू कंडक्ट द एक्सपेरिमेंट्स एंड अदर रिसर्च एक्टिविटीज, ठीक है. And guys, the last question for today, for increasing the production of nutri cereals under new National Food Security Mission program, the NFSM nutri cereals is being implemented in 212 districts of the country, of course to promote the production of nutri cereals, right. Aur kitne states mein ye 212 districts hai, so the number of state is 12. Option A is the correct answer. Alright, so that's it for today's session. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And I will see you in the next session on Wednesday. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.